Why? So let's turn to teaching notes page 2. So we will talk about occurrence of metal. Occurrence of metal. We will talk about the occurrence of metal. So basically most of the metal does not exist as free metal. What does that mean? For example, gold you can find 金礦, right? 你可以找到金礦, but can you find 鋁礦, right? Aluminium的礦, 你是不是找到? Right? So most of the metal actually exists as ore. Here you go. Okay, 礦石. Okay, most of the metal exists as ore in the earth. Okay, and some of them maybe you may have learned about previously. Okay, only some of the metal can exist as free element, and all of them are unreactive element. Make a guess why all the unreactive element exist as free element. Actually, all of you have the correct answer. Basically, for unreactive element, because they will not easily react with oxygen or water, so they will not form their corresponding ore. Okay, but for the reactive metal, or most of the metal, okay, they will exist in the earth as the ore. Okay, so what is the ore of those metal? So most of the ore are actually metal oxide or metal sulfide, or metal carbonate, these three. Okay, let's use these as the example. For example, aluminium. Okay, this one. The ore of aluminium, is actually aluminium oxide. Okay, so aluminium exists in the earth actually as aluminium oxide. And you can take a look of your book, page 7. Figure C, this one. Okay, this is the ore of aluminium. Okay, aluminium oxide. Okay, come down. Okay, and another example, copper. Okay, so copper exists as this one, copper pyrite. Okay, the main ingredient is this one. This is a complicated compound, so you just forget about the formula. Okay, but copper exists in the earth mainly as this form. And for iron, the main ore for iron is iron free oxide. Iron free oxide, this one. And for lead, all of lead is lead sulfide. Okay, so what we mentioned in the periodic table, the metal, are actually need to be extracted from the aluminium, from the metal ore. Okay, they will exist as the metal ore. So we need to take out the aluminium from the aluminium oxide in order to get this one. Okay, we need to take out the aluminium from the aluminium oxide. Okay. Understand with your hand. Okay, done. Okay, so for the MC, you can work on the MC on your own. Let's try MC number 4. Concept. Number 4.
Okay.
Okay, number four. So two most abundant element, most abundant metals in the earth craft should be aluminium and iron. Aluminium and iron. Okay, now take a look at the page 22, this section. Okay, and we will talk about this section later, but right now you should know the abundance of element in the earth. So what element actually has the take up most of the earth composition is oxygen. Okay, 71% of the earth mass is oxygen. Make a guess why. Water contains oxygen. How about the earth?
Silicon
and oxygen. There are 80% of the earth's surface is water. So you will think that hydrogen and oxygen should be the two most abundant element, right?
But why no hydrogen?
This is the question I ask you. How about the land? What is the composition of the land?
Silicon
dioxide, right? Okay, silicon dioxide. So in the ocean, on the land, in the air, also contain oxygen. So it is understandable why oxygen is the most abundant element, right? And for the second one, silicon. So you should know why silicon is the second most abundant, because the land contains silicon dioxide. Okay? And silicon is, although there are 80% water on the earth, but the land is much more heavier. It's much heavier than the water, right? So that's why the percentage of silicon is the second. And the third one, unexpectedly, is aluminium. Okay, because aluminium exists inside the land surface of the earth. Inside, aluminium is the third. Okay, iron is number five. Come on. Okay, so we finish section 1 and 2. Finish section 1 and 2.
Why no hydrogen?
Because hydrogen is light.
It's light. 因為一個hydrogen是1，RAM是1，但oxygen一個是16，那已經差很遠了。
Okay? Okay, so let's go to section 3. What I mentioned before, actually all the metal are extracted from their metal ore, right? So we need to learn how these metal are extracted from their corresponding ore. Okay. Before we talk about the method for extraction, we need to learn two important facts first. Number one, okay,
more reactive metal lose electron more readily, right? Understandable. And they will tend to form positive ion. For example, potassium. It will tend to form potassium ion, right? Okay, so after forming the potassium ion, let's say with oxygen, it will become potassium oxide, right? Okay, so this is more reactive metal. Let's use another metal as the example. For example, copper. Okay, copper is also metal. It will tend to lose electron. Okay, so it will tend to become copper 2-ion and form oxide with oxygen. Okay, so we know that potassium, comparing potassium and copper, this one is more reactive, right? Which means which one is less stable? K or copper?
Copper.
Less stable.
K.
Which one is less stable?
K.
K should be less stable, right? Then, how about the oxide? Which one should be more stable? K2O or CuO should be more stable. CuO should be more stable. No, why? No. CuO should be less stable. K2O should be more stable. Okay. We have mentioned K is less stable. K is less stable. So K will tend to become this form. Okay? So after forming the potassium oxide, it will not become potassium back easily, right? So K2O is more stable. But for copper, after forming the copper 2 oxide, if we want to convert copper into copper 2 oxide into copper, it is a relatively easy way to do so, right? 明白什麼？講多次。K want to become K plus, okay? Cu also want to become Cu 2 plus. After K become K plus, it don't want to turn back to K, right? But after copper turn to copper 2, it can turn to copper relatively easily. Understand what I mean?
Yes.
Because when potassium when potassium ion become potassium, it will become a less stable metal. It will become a reactive metal.
Oh, For more reactive metal, it will form a more stable ionic compound. In other words, it will form a more stable ore. 明嘅举手。 Okay? So given this information, let's go to 3.2. Let's go to 3.2. Okay? So take a look at this table. It is basically another metal reactivity series. The more reactive metal is in the higher is at the higher position. And generally, you can see four methods. Okay, number one, electrolysis. Number two, carbon reduction. Number three, heating alone. Number four, physical method. Right. Okay. So for these four methods, which method you think is the easiest method to take out the metal from the metal ore? Okay, physical method is the easiest method because, for example, gold and platinum, you can just 淘金啊. 其實淘金即係咩啫？將啲金面頭啲沙整走啫嘛。你明唔明啊？ 咁呢個咪最簡單嘅方法咯。Because this unreactive metal exists as free element in the earth, exists as free element, so it is the easiest method. Okay, for the second easiest method is heating alone. Heating alone.You just need to heat up, for example, silver oxide or mercury oxide, mercury 2 oxide. They will become silver and they will become mercury. Okay? So why we need a relatively difficult method to extract silver and mercury?Why we need a more difficult method to extract silver compared to gold? 得啦，大家答到啦。Okay, because mercury oxide or silver oxide, because mercury and silver is more reactive, so mercury oxide and silver oxide is more stable. So we need a more difficult method to extract them.OK, 明嘅舉手。OK, 呢度題外講一樣嘢，你哋有冇人咧試過細個打波或者屋企整瘀咗咧？屋企人叫你做一樣
綠雞蛋
係咪？
唔
係
冚汁佢咩？
綠雞蛋，你阿媽會話佢要放啲咩喺入面？
銀鏈
或者銀戒指嗰啲啦。碌完之後，知唔知佢嗰個銀會變咗咩？
變咗色
啊嘛，係嘛？
跟住阿媽就話有風
啊。係啊，阿媽話有風嘛。好啊，我問一問大家先嚇，問一問大家一樣嘢喎。What is the colour of silver oxide？ 唔記得㗎啦，大家係咪？啊 ，Let me tell you， silver oxide is black。
哦，咁等
我
翻啲。
Okay， so when you put the silver ring into the egg。After a period of time, what happened on the surface of silver ring? 你覺得佢面頭會做咗啲咩
？Form
oxide 或者 form 其他嘢係咪 ？Okay, let make a guess. How to turn the silver ring back to the silver ring?
整嗰個
嗰啲水㗎嘛，
洗銀水。
Yes, you just need to heat the silver black.
雞蛋熱
㗎。You just need to heat the black silver ring.It will become silver again.
但係只雞蛋熱喎。
但係佢入邊係一個環境，係充滿大量嘅 reactant 去 react with 佢啊嘛。
即係咧，你講啱唔啱？我唔明點解同時啲銀戒指會同普通嘅空氣
嘅。Actually, silver jewelry will turn black.If you use the silver jewelry for a very long time, it will turn black. This is one of the disadvantage of silver jewelry compared to gold jewelry. 係啊，但係你會唔會你會唔會幾勁貴買銀戒指之後熱佢啊？你唔會噶嘛？你明唔明啊？如果你上面刻住咗麥海晴好靚女咁，熱完冇咗，你明唔明先？
咁點解碌幾多會放？
但其實我剛才就老點過你們的，哎，死了錄了先。其實呢就不是 form oxide 的，是 form sulfide 的。不過呢我們等間會學這件事，其實 silver sulfide upon heating it will turn back to silver similarly 的 OK， 不過我未教你而已，所以不是 oxide， 但我講 oxide 你會明白的，因為你的蛋裡面其實是有硫的物質在這裡，它會 form sulfide 的，但是你當是 oxide 的理解是一樣的，明白嗎？我說什麼的舉手。 OK， 行了。媽，我純
粹想像不到什麼叫碌雞蛋和銀戒指。
對，為什麼碌雞蛋
放在你銀戒指裡面？
蛤？你這個就是這樣。 That's why traditional Chinese people need to learn chemistry, you know? Because all the Chinese people, when they see something color change, they will blame, for example, blame the devil.They will blame 咩咩碌咗啲風出嚟，見到轉顏色就話碌咗啲風出嚟，傻傻地真係。
即係咪？
Actually, it is not the 魚血咯 ，it is just the silver have chemical reaction.
咁樣就係真係
明唔明啊？得唔得先？我媽細個係會係真係會放隻銀戒指落去噶，我大個咗之後就話佢咯。係啊，好迷信啊嘛！你見到隻銀擺入去之後，見到有黑色，你啲魚血有黑色，你咪以為吸咗佢出嚟咯。其實就唔關事嘅。碌雞蛋有用燒魚咧，係因為佢熱，佢熱令到你加速血液循環快啲，嚿魚血散啫，就唔關你入邊放唔放銀戒指事嘅。Because the Chinese people need to learn chemistry, OK? 食唔食都係睇你自己點嘅，啲人話跌咗跌嘢落地下三秒都食得㗎，係咪先？一樣道理咯。你自己諗下啦。
點解
啊？
我真
係
要
二
三秒拎出嚟。
好。OK 啦嚇。OK 咯，嗱 ，another example for you。Silver oxide 有冇銀戒指啊 ？Mercury oxide。Mercury oxide is not common actually, but another mercury compound is common. Mercury sulfide. Mercury sulfide 咩色？
綠色可以。
軟粒嘅。紅色嘅，紅色嘅。我之前教你嘅 mercury 好多都係佢嘅 compound 都紅色噶嘛。What is mercury sulfide? Mercury sulfide is actually 朱砂，中國古代用嘅紅色顏料係咪？朱砂。So。Make a guess, make a guess 啊 ，make a guess. What happened? What happened when you heat up the 朱砂？
融咯，變翻液體。
It will turn back to mercury 咯，就係咁咯。然後熱嘅時候 ，mercury will turn to mercury vapor 咯 ，which is toxic gas 咯。所以古代朱砂咪話有毒咯，就係咁解啫嘛，你明唔明啊？
朱砂
字，
咁咪唔 heat 佢咯？
唔 heat 佢都得，咁但係佢，咁但係你都會掂到噶嘛？或者佢即係係咯，你或者你溝佢嘅時候，佢有其他化學反應，咪可能會令到 mercury 進入你身體咯。中國人真係要讀化學啦，唉。OK， 好。咁啊，so we have learned about。Heating metal all along. So for this class of metal ore, okay, I just use oxide as the example. All of them, copper 2 oxide. 你見過嘅其實 copper 2 oxide 有冇見啲水喉管咧用得耐變黑啊？真正嘅銅喉係啡噶嘛，但係佢放得耐佢會變黑啦。咁你話黑色嗰啲係咩？Copper 2 oxide, okay. Lead oxide, lead oxide. Iron 3 oxide. What is iron 3 oxide? 鐵鏽啦 ，okay. Zinc oxide 啊 ，zinc oxide 啦嚇，咁咪冇嘢。So we have discussed about the relative stability right here. So make a guess. Zinc oxide or silver oxide is more stable.有兩班人答唔同答。Zinc oxide or silver oxide is more stable.
Zinc oxide.
Zinc oxide should be more stable 啊 ，Zinc oxide should be more stable， 係咪？係啊係啊 ，Zinc oxide should be more stable. So the conclusion is that we need a more difficult method to extract the zinc from zinc oxide, right?We need a more difficult method to extract iron from iron 3 oxide. We need a more difficult method to extract copper from copper 2 oxide compared to the lower metal ore, right? So what is the method? We call it carbon reduction. Or you can say just heated with carbon. Just heated with carbon. Okay?你擺啲鐵鏽入去，倒啲碳落去，熱佢，熱完之後就會出翻啲鐵出嚟。就係咁啦，明唔明？呢度又要講另外一個故仔啦，又係去展述點解中學人需要讀化學啦。OK， 中國古代係咪煉丹啊？煉丹嗰啲丹係咩丹嚟㗎？即唔係，即唔係 mercury 係其中一樣啦。但係中國人古代煉丹煉咗出嚟一丹咩係咪閃靈靈嘅啊？閃靈靈㗎嘛。好啦， 你估中國人古代煉丹揾咩入去煉嘅？嗱，中國古代咧煉丹咧，to be fair 咧，中國人古代煉丹咧就係乜鬼都掉落去煉嘅。咁佢哋會掉啲咩落去啦？譬如哦，見到棵樹，見到城，又掉落去啦。見到啲礦石又掉落去咯。見到啲石頭又掉落去啦。跟住煉煉氣佢，好啦。咁咧有一日咧就可能無啦啦有個中國人咧就掉咗啲即係嗰啲 mercury 嘅礦石入去，跟住咧又掉咗啲iron 嘅礦石入去，又掉咗啲 lead 嘅礦石入去，嗰啲好似石頭咁嘅嘢啊，又掉棵樹入去，掉啲草藥嗰啲入去燒。好啊，你話燒完嗰啲草啊樹啊嗰啲變咗咩啊？
灰。
嗰啲灰係咩嚟㗎？燒完棵樹變咗啲咩？變咗嚿碳啦，係咪？好啊。咁佢就話啲碳又掉埋呢啲咁嘅鐵嘅嗰啲生鏽礦石入去，掉完之後熱佢。好啦 ，After studying chemistry, let's tell me 會變咗乜嘢啊？變咗嚿鐵咯。咁咪閃靈靈咯。食完之後嫦娥就點啊？嫦娥升仙咯。咁你哋下個禮拜就有多日假啦。好嘅。是不是就是这样的事。That's why Chinese people need to study chemistry. True story, so true. OK, 然后另外一个为什么会成为用 Mercury 去炼丹呢？因为 Mercury 是液体，它本身就能够溶解这些金属，所以炼了出来粒丹就会好更加闪亮亮。这些人炼
丹最好
就練埋先咯，跟住就明唔明啊 ？OK， so these four metal ore， need to use a more difficult method for metal extraction， which is carbon reduction。OK， 好啦 ，for aluminium， magnesium or calcium， sodium， potassium。OK， their oxide need to use a very expensive and very difficult method。Only exist after the invention of electricity， OK， until 人類懂得用電才可以做到這件事、electrolysis， OK， 硬硬將 aluminium oxide turn back to aluminium， OK， 將 aluminium oxide turn back to aluminium， OK， so we have this method electrolysis for molten ore。 什麼是 molten ore 呢？ molten 你懂的，熱到它溶，熱到它溶 ，OK， molten ore。So this is the trend down the metal reactivity series. Down the metal reactivity series, it will be easier to extract the metal from the metal ore. 明唔明先？明我講乜嘅手 ？OK， and the price of extraction will be cheaper. 係咪？淘金唔使錢嘅，需要用具係咩啊？烧机啊，系咪？炼丹要咩用具啊？啊，唔系就咁热佢要咩用具啊？要火啦，系咪？要木头咯，要蜡烛啦，起码都。Carbon reduction 要咩啊？你起码有个炼丹炉啦，系咪 ？Electrolysis 要咩啊？就要电啦，系咪？所以呢、這个就 summarize 咗我哋要学嘅啦。OK， for more reactive metal。It will form a more stable metal ore. For a more stable metal ore, it requires a much difficult and much expensive method to extract the metal back. Understand? 明明我講乜？明嘅舉手。明唔明？好。
升到 copper 嗰度嗰啲，可唔可以即係嗰啲話可唔可以係冇層膜？即係你放冇電控之後，佢哋可唔可以變到 liquid state？
邊
度揾啲molten ore翻嚟？即係你已經好高
温，
變咗即
係
上面嗰啲
electrolysis
嗰啲
係
molten ore。
係。
咁下面呢一集可唔可以molten？
可以，但
係
你要熱到夠高温度咯。
即
係
都可以。
咁你熱到幾千度，咁肯定佢會變咗液體嘅。
咁點解要強調上面嗰啲係molten ore？
因為唔molten咪導唔到電咯。Ionic compound need to only conduct electricity when it when it is in molten state or aqueous solution
即
係
molten state 就俾你 electrolysis。
係啊。
哦，即係行嘅嘢都可以 molten state， 但係佢哋唔需要 electrolysis。
Yes。Yes。就係咁咯。你未知道呢個名字，你就咁當係 heating with carbon 就 OK 啦。Heating with carbon 就 OK 啦，得唔得 ？OK。明唔明啊？呢度好明啊嘛，有冇機會喺 cam 咧見下咧？係有嘅，但係咧 ，before we take a look of it in cam 咧 ，we take a look of it in YouTube， 唔使啦 ，search my channel。Experiment for extraction of silver from silver oxide. Extraction of silver from silver oxide. So let's tell me how to extract silver oxide from silver. How to extract silver from silver oxide? Heating along, right? Okay, so silver oxide is black powder. So I do. Can you see? Can you see?So this is the extraction method for silver oxide. For silver oxide, okay. We can extract silver from silver oxide just by heating. Okay, 得咯喎。下一個 ，What if we want to extract copper oxide? Want to extract copper from copper oxide? What is the method? Carbon reduction. Take a look ah.
Experiment will heat together a mixture of black carbon powder and black copper oxide.
等等先 Color of copper oxide.
Black.
Color of copper.
Brown.
Color of carbon.
Gold. Carbon.
Black. 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 So before the reaction, we have copper, which is black. Copper oxide, which is.Black. So two black powder mixed together. After the reaction, we have, you don't know what. After the reaction, you have copper and carbon dioxide. When you take a look of the chemical equation, you will know. You have carbon dioxide and copper. Okay? So you will see the black solid turn to
brown.
And some gas will be this. Although you can't see it, but you can test the gas by...Carbon dioxide test by burning speed. Lime water, 唉，救命啊，真係，唉，你翻去讀中二啊。
The gas evolved is passed into a solution of calcium hydroxide, that is lime water.
係，其實 lime water 係 calcium hydroxide， 你而家未學嘅 ，chapter 14嘅時候我哋會學噶，你當係 lime water 就得㗎。
Notice the white precipitate of calcium carbonate.Formed as the evolved gas passes through the lime water. This shows that carbon dioxide is produced. As the black mixture is heated, the copper oxide is reduced to red copper by the carbon, which is itself being oxidized to carbon dioxide. After the tube has cooled, we can see the copper that has been...
Give me that. Copper metal. Copper metal. 上面嗰啲鹽度 ，so remain copper oxide and carbon， OK， but the lower part copper two oxide react with carbon to give copper and carbon dioxide， so you can see copper right here， red color change， or brown，
OK。When they took out the mixture at the conclusion of the experiment, you can see that it is now red-brown due to the copper produced by the reduction of copper oxide.
Okay? Okay, so the next one, aluminium oxide. So what is the method of extraction of aluminium from aluminium oxide? Electrolysis. 都要俾你睇下嘅，如果唔係你冇概念。呢條片有啲長嘅。
Occur in a natural state.The most available source of alumina is actually.
呢度開始就差唔多。
The most available source of alumina. Aluminum, so widely used today, and the world's most abundant metallic element, does not occur in a natural state.
呢個明唔明
白？
啱啱佢明唔明佢講咩 ？The most abundant metal element does not exist as free element state. 啱啱講，聽得明啊？聽唔聽到啊？聽多次。
Aluminum, so widely used today, and the world's most abundant metallic element, does not occur in a natural state.
Natural state 即係唔係 as aluminium solid in the nature, okay?
Most available source of aluminum is actually bauxite.
Bauxite.
Bauxite is mainly mined in tropical countries.The aluminum atom in
mainly mined in tropical country, 即係喺熱帶嘅國家嗰度去採礦嘅。
Bauxite is bonded to oxygen molecules. These bonds have to be broken by electrolysis to produce pure aluminum. Bauxite is carried by rail to the plant where it will be crushed. Then, through a chemical transformation called the Bayer process, alumina is extracted.This is then roasted in calciners to eliminate all moisture. This is the reduction facility. This plant has 432 pots through which a powerful electric current will be passed to produce electrolysis. An overhead crane dumps alumina into the pots. Then the electric current from the anode passes through the alumina that we see here at the bottom of the pot.
呢啲就係 box 嗰啲鋁嘅礦石，鋁嘅礦石有個名噶，叫咩 ？box 嘅中文係鋁土礦。
Via the process of alumina reduction at 1742 degrees.
1742 degree. Okay. So at this high temperature, aluminium oxide will turn to liquid or molten state.Okay, molten state， 所以你見到呢度啊，火光紅紅就係嗰啲爛熔爛石嗰啲鐵嘅石融咗去變成為液體。OK。
The anodes lose volume and will have to be replaced. It's a continuous operation. Each anode has a lifespan of about 20 days.
呢個加熱啫。
The anodes are recovered from the pot with this overhead crane and carried off to be recycled.
呢個攞嚟加熱嘅呢嚿嘢。
They clean the aluminum.
嗰啲唔睇咁多啦，佢講嗰啲工。
The anode. When the anodes are replaced, the electric current breaks the molecular bonds. The heavier aluminum collects at the bottom of the pot, while the oxygen bound to fluorine is released as a gas, which is drawn off and treated.Liquefied aluminum remains at the bottom of the pot. It has to be recovered in this huge crucible with a tube. The tube is dipped into the bottom of the pot, and a vacuum system vacuum from the crucible by a flexible pipe held by.
佢又而家呢度係最後一個 process 啦 ，heat up 個 aluminium， turn the aluminium to liquefied aluminium， 液體嘅鋁，然後就拎將佢提出嚟，得唔得？
Operator dumps another quantity. is uninterrupted. The crucibles filled with molten aluminum are transported to the casting house. Their contents are poured into holding furnaces that have a capacity of 60 tons. In these very hot furnaces, the molten aluminum is stored to await casting. Finally, casting begins. The aluminum can be semi-continuously vertically cast, producing ingots, sheets or billets, or it can be directly cast into semi-finished products.
呢度全部都係液體嘅aluminium嚟㗎，OK，得唔得？有啲長呢度，係嘛 ？OK， so we have learned the, these four metal extraction methods. So we have learned these four metal extraction methods.And after learning this, we need to know the chemical equation. First of all, word equation. For metal, for the least reactive metal, for example, mercury and silver, okay, their metal oxide can react just by heating and become metal and oxygen. So let's try to write down the chemical equation of extraction of silver. 唔好睇你本嘢，
自己寫嗰個 reaction 啫。
Work equation or just chemical equation for silver. So silver oxide upon heating become silver and oxygen. So write down the chemical equation for me. Okay.So for the reaction for silver oxide, okay? So silver oxide, first of all, you need to know the chemical formula of silver oxide. So silver ion, Ag plus, oxide ion, O2 minus. So to give a silver oxide, the chemical formula will be Ag2O, okay? And silver oxide upon heating will become silver.And oxygen, right? Okay, so when you take a look of my chemical equation, I will give a word heat above the arrow, right? So you can also write a heat above the arrow, or we have another symbol for this. 三角形
Delta.
Delta can be represented as heating in chemistry, but.This is not quite common in DSE, but it is very common in the old chemistry syllabus. So I would suggest you just write heating, okay? Okay, so this chemical equation is not balanced, so you need to balance the chemical equation. Okay? So this is the balanced chemical equation for the extraction of silver solid from the silver oxide solid metal ore.In which the reaction will give our oxygen gas as the product. Okay? Understand how to write these chemical equations. Okay? So let's go to the another method, which is, how do we call this method?
Carbon
reduction or heat tank with carbon. Okay? So it is for the relatively less reactive metal from zinc to copper, okay? So the word equation is metal oxide react with carbon to give metal and carbon dioxide. So let's try to work on the, 寫個簡單啲啊。lead two oxide.Anyone need more time? Okay. So for lead 2 oxide, first of all, lead 2 ion, Pb2 plus, oxide, O2 minus. So lead 2 oxide should be PbO. Okay? React with carbon to give lead metal and carbon dioxide. Right? Okay?So let's balance the chemical equation. Okay, this is the balanced chemical equation. 一個 one carbon, two oxygen, okay, two lead, solid, gas, okay. 不如買你哋。 What is the observable change?
Sunshine.
What is the color of that?
Black.
Yellow and hot, white and cool.
那個不是青的，是那個是什麼？我都記錯了。
是 red, orange and red, yellow and cold.
Okay. Now of course it is very tricky color. Very tricky color. So I don't think in HKDSE it requires to memorize all these colors. But some of the general color you need to memorize. For example, metal oxide, what is the color? Metal oxide, what is the color?
Black.
Metal oxide, main group oxide, all of them are white, right? For first 20 elements, all the oxide are bright and white. Okay, so you know this reaction, chemical equation. Okay, for this one, potassium to aluminium. For the most reactive metal, we need to use electrolysis to extract the metal from the metal ore, right? So let's try to write down the reaction for aluminium oxide. Aluminium oxide. For this reaction, aluminium oxide. So first of all, write down aluminium oxide. Aluminium ion, Al3+, oxide, O2-. So you need to balance the chemical formula first. So you have Al2O3 to give aluminium and oxygen gas, right? After that, you need to balance the chemical equation. So this is 2, so you need to... Okay, so this is the chemical equation, but if you want to know the state symbol, so pay attention to this case. We just check the video. So in the real situation for the electrolysis of aluminium oxide, the aluminium oxide is at what state? Liquid or solid state? Liquid state. Molten state. So which is liquid? Aluminium also liquid state. Yes. Okay. So these are the extraction method and their corresponding chemical equation. Okay. But I think the most valuable part in this lesson is that you need to know the trend. You need to know the trend because you can work on the right tank of chemical equation on your own. But for the trend, basically you need to be taught. Okay? For the more reactive metal, it will form a more stable metal ore. It will form a more stable metal ore, which require a more difficult and expensive method for the metal extraction. Okay? So this is the trend right here. Okay.